Hello everybody, welcome to the next lecture on the evolutionary algorithms. Today we will discuss about the cuckoo search algorithm. Myself, Dr. Garg, which are working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, Patiala, India. So this video will explain the working of the cuckoo search algorithm with this simple numerical example, that is a unconstrained optimization problem, minimization of the certain function over the domain state. So firstly, what is the cuckoo search is there? This cuckoo search is initially proposed by the Zhang and Dave in 2009, you can find their the paper which is described the cuckoo search by Lewis Flight in here. So this is inspired by the behavior of the cuckoos. So it is inspired by the obedient brood pairs of the some cuckoo species by laying their eggs in the nest of the other host birds. We all know that in the nest of the birds, especially in the cuckoos and the others are there, the eggs are always from the some other host are there. So what will they then? So some other hosts are either engaged directly conflicts with the cuckoos, or otherwise, for example here, if the host bird discovered that the egg are not their own, then either they will throw the egg or simply abandon their nest rather. For example, in this picture you can see these five eggs are their cuckoos own, while this one is some other host bird egg is there. So what the cuckoos will do, that either they can destroy or either they can throw this egg or they can abandon its eggs and produce the new nest is there. So these two lines or these two phenomena are the basic motivation of their cuckoo search algorithms. So what is that? The evolutionary process of the cuckoo search is basically divided into these three portions are there, so that you can easily able to understand the working of this cuckoo search algorithm. First one is the Lewis flight, which is the main role is to generate a new solution. Once you generate a new solution, then you will check whether they are improve your fitness value or not, and then you will replace some nest with a new solution with the help of this line. Either they can throw or they can abandon the solution, and finally we can preserve the best value until our goal will decide that. So the Lewis flight, the behavior of this cuckoo search is a Lewis flight. It is used to generate the new solution with the help of, as all we all know that in every algorithm, either of the PSO genetic algorithm, we always use the production of the new solution, that is x new, with the help of the current solution plus random times the something. Or while you know that how you generate the new solution is x plus h, this h is the step length. So same thing for here, this random into c, where c is nothing but the change of the position, and it is defined like this way. Here r, a and d is called as the random number. It's a random number which are normally distributed. In other distribution or in other evolutionary algorithms like PSO, artificial bee colony, gravitational search algorithms, and all these randoms are uniformly distribution random number between 0, 1. But here is a random number which are distributed normally. So here is the difference between them. What is the S? S is nothing but the step length or the step size, which represents a random step size and is symmetrically generated with the help of the Lewy distribution. So that's why this is called as the Lewy flight, because here the step length or the step size is distributed with the help of Lewy distribution, which are defined like this way, u divided by v of this. What is the u, v and beta is? Beta is most generally denoted as 1.5, while u and v are the normally distributed, whose mean are 0, and variances are defined as sigma u and sigma v square, where sigma u is defined like this way, where this gamma is called as the gamma distribution and v is denoted as here. So what is the meaning is that in the Lewis flight, we will generate the new solution. If you substitute c here, you will get this number c plus random times x nu is here, where s is denoted by calculated by this way, u and v are, and sigma u is calculated by this way. And this best represents for the best solution in the solution so far, or we call as the G best, global best so far. This is the first phase of the cuckoo search working. The second phase is you can replace the nest with a new solution. So either they can throw away or abandon. So instead of the throwing away the whole nest, they have to choose some fraction. I donated as a PA, and in mostly PA is called as probability, that's generated as a 1/4. So how is that? We will how to generate the new solution. We will generate the random number between 0 1. We will check whether this random number is less than of the PA, that is assigned probability. If satisfied, we will generate the new solution, and this new solution is generated by this value, that is a previous value plus a random number which are lies between 0 and 1, and the difference between the two random numbers which are taken from their solution. So we will see with the help of the numerical example. So let's do that. In the cuckoo search, we need only the three parameters which we have to set before start of the cuckoo search algorithm. So one is the population size, second is the number of the generations, and third is the probability for using the generation of the new solution. So remember, we have used this. So remember that what is the dimension of this problem is x1 and x2. So our task is to fill these values, and the corresponding fitness values are there. So let's start with them. So initially, we will generate the random number between the domain, so -5 to +5. And since how to generate the random number is by using this rule, lower number, that is -5, plus any random number which are lies between 0, 1, and upper number is 5, and minus of -5. So based on this, you can generate the 5 nests, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and you will get this. So this value is corresponding to x1. This is column second corresponding to x2. Once we generate the x1 and x2, we will calculate the fitness value by using this. And since the problem is minimization, and since we need the beta is already known to you, and we have to calculate sigma u, after substituting here, we will get this. And out of this fitness value, which one is the best position is, since my task is minimized, so which is minimum is this, and the corresponding solution is called as the best solution. Now we will use the first one. So what is that? For the first solution, this is the for my first nest, we will generate the u and v by using this. Sigma u I have calculated in the last slide. See, look at that. And best solution we have also calculated in the last slide here. So based on this, we will generate the u and v. Again, I said that r, a, and d, n is the normally distributed random number. Okay, so based on this, we will get u and v are there. So these are the random numbers are there. Once we know u and v, we will calculate s, u divided by v, and so on, because we need to calculate the x new by this. X, we already know that these are my x for the first nest. This is my x. Random n is the random number which we will generate. 0.01 is the constant number. S is we calculate here. X is this, and best is this one. Now we will calculate this one for the first nest with respect to x1 and x2. So we will start with the x1. So what is the x for the x1 is -4.5861, plus this number is the random number, so which is generated randomly, 0.01. S for the first position is minus this times x. This is my x minus x best. So this is my best position. So after solving this, you will get this, and it lies between our domain -5 to +5. Similarly, we will calculate the x2 for this position first nest. What we'll do is, this is my x plus random number. So this is the random number generated, uniformly random number generated, 0.01. S, this is my s, multiply with the x, and minus of the best, so minus minus of plus, and again it lies between -5 to 5. So therefore my x new for the first nest will be -4. This and so on. So can I replace this x with this new x? So that will be decided with the help of greedy selection. So we will calculate f fitness value at this x new, that will be here, and the fitness value of the x original value is this. So since my task is to minimize the function, so which one is minimum? So this is minimum, So we preserve this and delete the value of this one. So what we do is, we will, since this is better than of the previous one, so we will update the x. It means we will delete this value of here, and this value we can substitute here, and the value of f is here. So look at that, this one. Now do the same thing for the second nest. We will calculate the firstly u, we will calculate the v, and we will calculate the s. So we will again, sigma u is here, we will again generate the random number and so on. So for the second nest, we will use this one. So calculate the x for here. Look at that, the value of this is minus of this plus random number generated 0.01 of s, this is my s, times x minus of the x best. Again, it lies between minus 5 to plus 5. Similarly, we will calculate this for the x2, we will here, and then x new will be here. So can I replace this x new with the help of the newly generated, that decided with the help of the greedy selection. So the new fitness value calculated here, original value of the fitness is 37.1741. So which one is better? Is this is better. So it means f of x is better. So there is no need to use or update the value of x. So we will copy this x here. So look at that, we will use the same x here. Now we will do the same for the third nest. We will calculate u, again randomly generated numbers, normally distributed, we will calculate here, and calculate the x1 and x2 for this third position, that is minus 0.8. this is the random number generated, this is the value of the xs, x minus g best best value, and so on. And you can see that both value lies between minus 5 to 5, and the value of the x new is here. We will check whether we will replace this x new with the help of the previous value. We will perform the greedy selection. Look at that, the value of the x new position fitness value here, and the original value is this value. So which one is better? So f x new is better. So there is need to update the value. So we will use this value and delete this previous value. So look at minus 0.8218 is the updated value. Do the same thing for the fourth nest, and we will calculate u, v, and s, and then calculate the value of the x1 and x2 and so on. Okay, so we will perform the greedy selection. So look at that, the x new is better than of the previous value. So we will update this, we will delete this value and replace this value here, and do the same thing for the last nest. So we will do the same thing for here, calculate u, v, s, and then we will perform the x1 and x2 for the next position, x1, this is a random number generated, and so on. So we will calculate this number, perform the greedy selection. We will see that this both value are same, so there is no need to update the value, or you can update the value because these values are same. So these values are, you can copy this as such. So since there is no more nests are there, so it means after the first phase, the updated positions are this one. Now we will move to the next phase, that is replace some nest with the help of this. So we will decide, we will assign the value of PA as the 0.25. This is a standard value which is used everywhere. So here we will need the D1 and D2, which are randomly generated from 1 to N. What is the N is? What is the N is population size. Look at this. So we will generate the N from 1 to 5. So what we'll do is, for the first nest, we will firstly check, generate the random number. Okay. So since there are the two X1 and X2, so we will generate the two random number. And D1 and D2 are the two random number from 1 to 5. I used 1 and 3. These are the randomly generated. Now, and the value of the PA is assigned to be a 0.25. Now we will perform, check whether R is less than of the 0.25 or not. This we can do for the X1 separately and X2 separately. So what is that? Now check whether this number is less than of the 0.25. No. So it means there is no need to update the position. So it means the first value for the x1 for the first nest is remains same. Now do the same thing for the other. Check for this r whether this is less than of this. Yes. So we will update the x with the help of this value. So how you check that? This x2, this is the value for the first nest, x2 value this. Look at that, minus 3.9554 plus random number generated. What is the d1? That is 1. Okay, so that is x of, now since we are working for the x2, so this is my x1. What is the d2? Is my x3. So look at that, the value of the x, this number is my this, and x of 3, the value of the x2 for the x3 is my this. So after solving, you will get this, and it lies between minus 5 to plus 5. So therefore, we calculate the x new, x1 is remains same, so this is there. So can we replace this value with the help of this? We will again perform the greedy selection. So calculate the fitness value at this point, we will calculate this, and the original value are here. So since the newly calculated value is better than of this in terms of minimization, so we will update the position. So we will delete this number and replace this value with here. So look at that, we will this one. Now do the same thing for the second nest. Again we will generate the two random number, one for the x1 and x2. Generate the random number for the d1 and d2. I use both as a 5 and 5. Now check whether the random number is less than of the PA. Okay, PA is nothing but my 0.5, so 0.25. So first number is not be less than, so there is no need to update. The first number is same as such. Check for the second number. This is less than, so we will update this value. So how you update? So we will use this equation. Now for the second nest, what is the x2 value? So 4.1747. R and D is the random number generated between 0, 1, x of D, that is 5. So what is the x5? Is this is my x5. So this is my first this value. What is the D2? Is again 5. So this is remains same. So that's why this like this. So after solving, we will get this number. So can we replace this value? Again perform the greedy selection. So since both value are same, so either you can update or not, that depending upon you. So since the value are same, so we will replace this value with this here. Now similarly do the same thing for the third nest. We will generate the random number this and this, and the d1 and d2 are randomly generated from the population size 1 to 5. I consider as 4 and 3. Now check whether again r is less than of the PA or not. Look at that, the first number is less than of this, so we will update the x1 by using this. So what is the x1 for here is this number plus random number generated. What is the d1? Is my 4. So this is my x4. What is the fourth position of the x1? Is here 1.7398 minus, what is the d2? Is my 3. So third x3, what is the x3 of the x1? Is there. So here is minus minus plus. So after solving, you will get this number. And similarly for the x2 position, since this is not greater than of the 0.25, so there is no update for the x2. So x2 remains the same, 4.3220. So now after this, you will get this number. So can we replace this number? So it will decide the greedy selection. Calculate the new position, we will get this, and the previous value is my 41.5516. Since the new value better than of the previous value, so we will update the value of the x with the x new. So we will use this value here, that is minus 0.23 and so on. Do the same thing for the next. So we will generate the two random numbers and the two d1 and d2. So look at that, whether this number is less than. Yes. So for the fourth position, we will use this. What is the x1? Is 1.7398. We will use the random number. What is the d1? Is my 3. So what is the x3 for the x1? So this is my x3 for the x1. What is the x2? X2 is my this for the x1, because we are working on the x1. So minus minus plus. So again it lies between minus 5 to plus 5. Similarly, we will check for the x2. So whether this number is less than for the x2 or not, it is not. So we will take x2 as such. So we will generate the new number as this one. So whether we replace this or not, we will perform the greedy selection and we will look that this is better than of the previous value. So it means we will again update the position. So we will update this value and here and delete this value from their solution. Now look at for the last value, because since this is the last population size, if there are more population size, you can do the same thing for the others. So I generate the random numbers and the 2, D1 and D2. So look at that, since the first number is less than of the 0.25, so we will update this value. First number is this random number, D1 is my 2, so x of 2 is my this, minus what is that, D2 is my 1, so this is my x1 for this. So this is minus minus plus, we will calculate this number as here. And similarly for the second, again this is less than, so we will perform the this operation for the x2 again. So for the fifth, this is my x value. What is the x1 of the d2? So this is 4.17, this minus what is the x of this is 1, so x of 1 is here. So we will calculate this number. So can we perform the greedy selection or not? So we will replace this value, check whether which one is better. So since 4 point this is better than of the 41.6, so it means we will update this value as here. So there is no update the value, so we will copy this value as such. Now since there is no more values are there and second phase also over, so it means the first iteration is complete. So that means we will complete the update the solution and we will update value as here. So that's the end of the first iteration. Now we will move, we will update the iteration. Now for the second iteration, what we'll do is, we will need sigma u. This is fixed value we have calculated already. So what is the best value we have calculated again here? So what is the best value is this value. So the corresponding number is this. So this is my best. Now perform the x new value again by using again the rule of this 0.01 s x minus best for this first position, second, third and so on, and then we will update the values again and again. So we will see that at the end of the first value this, we will update the value up to the 20th iteration, at the end of the fifth iteration this. Look at that, the value, since my problem is minimization, so once it entered to the fifth iteration, the values improve. Second value is improved, third value is improved and so on. So once you are completed the fifth iteration, complete again, check the best value. So now this time best value is here. Okay, so this is my best. Now move to the 10th iteration. So again you can see that each solution is updated, move on the 20th iteration and so on. So if you run this as a 100 times, you will see that the graph of the iteration wise fitness value with respect to iteration is converges to some values out there. So this is the simple working of the cuckoo search algorithms. So I hope you can enjoy and learn this cuckoo search algorithm in an efficient manner. The next lecture I will explain the working of some other algorithms such as the gravitational search algorithms and the BBO or the other algorithm. Till then you can subscribe the channel for more details. You can put up the comments. Thank you very much too.